next Myrmidon is a local Nord named Vald. I wouldn't get too close to him if I were you. Just take my word on that, is all I can say. Follow me.
Gold for another Myrmidon match. Well done.
You didn't let that vampire touch you, did you? Don't get too close to me if you did. Anyways, you've defeated two Myrmidons, and that earns you a new rank. So, you are no longer a pit dog, and I award you the rank of Myrmidon. All Myrmidon challengers fight warrior-level opponents. And you've drawn a very crafty and unpredictable spellcaster named Ulnareal. Follow me to the pit.
Ladies and gentlemen, take your places for our next match! From the red team, please welcome your Altmer warrior, Ulnareal the Unbeaten! The blue team, fresh off two victories, our newest Myrmidon, Shadow Beast. Our fighters are ready to do battle. Let the match begin.
Yeah.
anywhere. We have more matches coming up.
Well, you certainly handled that elf like a seasoned warrior. I hereby advance you in rank to brawler class. For this fight, one of our gladiators has arrived from Cyrodiil just in time to face you. His name is Brutus, and he is a veteran fighter. So watch yourself. Follow me.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back! For this match, let's hear a round of applause for your gladiator, Brutus! Warrior! Shadow Base! Fighters, take your positions and let the match begin!
Follow me to the pit.
Good evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, take your places for our next match! Yeah. From the red team, please welcome our hero from High Rock, Tyrannus! From the blue team, fresh from a mauling defeat of Brutus, welcome back, Shadow Mage! Fighters, take your position and let the match begin!
Everyone, including our current Grand Champion. He has requested a match with you, so we are going to forego the customary procedure and let you fight. And I hereby promote you to Gladiator. Make no mistake, this Khajiit is champion for a reason. He is one tough opponent. I hope you're ready for this. Follow me.
Gentlemen, we have something special for you for our last match. Yeah. our grand champion, has returned to Skyrim! Please welcome back to the pit, Subra! And our challenger from the blue team, please welcome back Shadowmane! Fighters, take your positions! And let the match begin! Champion has been defeated! Stick around, we will have more matches later on!
Fiber to gold for defeating a champion. I wouldn't have believed it if I didn't see it with my own eyes. Well done.
Did you ever? We haven't had a challenger that exciting. I can't remember when. Of course I am. But I'm sure you can see how addictive it can become, can't you? Why? You do have a short temper, don't you? Why so angry? Well, you'll get your lumber soon enough. Please tell Mr. Janus. I will have a shipment out for him tomorrow. No one is getting swindled by me. Oh yes, that. How about the first two shipments are free of charge, and I can take off, say, 10% for the rest. Here is a new contract for Mr. Janus. Please give him my warmest regards, will you? You're right. Goodbye.
Private tower suitable. Can I help you, friend? What? New contracts? Discounts, you say? What happened? Maybe so. But I'll bet it will make for quite a tale to tell your grandchildren around a campfire someday. Ah, how I envy you. If only I were but a younger man. Forgive my mindless ramblings of younger days. It's just an old soldier's dreams. Anyway, this says we'll receive a considerable savings, and the shipments will begin immediately. Well done. Now we can get that old inn finished and start on the rest of the town. No, you've worked yourself out of a job with me. And again, thank you. But I believe Valerius has more information for you. Please see him at your earliest convenience.
Marcus and I catching up. Two old warhorses talking about the good days.
Yes. Wanted to be absolutely certain before I spoke with you, but it's been confirmed by my sources. There is indeed a slavery network in operation here in Skyrim, and all clues point to my old nemesis Arendil as its chief operator. They're capturing citizens, whole families, and even their children, and selling them as slaves. I'm afraid only the gods know what's happening to these poor souls after that. Arendil has certainly covered his tracks well, so we have very little, if anything, to go on. All we know is that he specifically requested a transfer here, and to be assigned as overseer of all prison operations in Skyrim. It was certainly convenient, was it not? Be that as it may, fortunately one of their guards had loose lips at precisely the right moment. And you may remember Korst saying he spoke of his relationship with some whore at the Tallmast Tavern. I know, it's not much, but maybe she can provide us with something else to investigate. Can you see what you can find out from her? Here, I'll mark it on your map.
Well, baby, I only provide one kind of service here. And information, ain't it? Besides, I never kiss and tell. What you see is what you get with me, sugar. So, if you're not interested in my company, I suggest you go to the bar and leave me be. Maybe I know a little, but I was hoping to get to know each other a little better. About him? Nothing much. He's been here to see me a time or two. Not very, impressive, if you ask me. But that's another story. Hold on, sweetie. I'm getting to it. All I really know is that another one of the girls said someone else came in here looking for him yesterday. She said instead of a tall mast, he was more like a limp sail. But she said he sure did his share of talking. I guess if you can't be good at, you know, something else, talking is the next best thing. She said he was one of those kind you wouldn't want to tell any secrets to, if you know what I mean. He said his name was Maenen. Anyway, he said he would be taking his ship out of Solitude back home soon. For all I know, he might still be there. Now, if you don't need me for anything else, I have customers to take care of. That's a pity, honey.
Speak, Elf. What? Who? You must be mistaking me for someone else. I know no one by that name. What? That's absolutely preposterous. Yes, I know I'm probably no match for you. I'm only armed with a little dagger. You wouldn't kill a defenseless man now, would you? Very well, I will talk. But only if you guarantee me you'll let me sail back home. I don't know. I never met him, actually. I only met with one of his associates, an old bandit named Goonlock. Some say his last name is Forktar, but I wouldn't know about that for sure. All I know is that Erendil sends the product to Goonlock, and he takes care of getting them smuggled out of Skyrim. I don't know exactly where he is, but I know they smuggle the product out of Skyrim from an old shipwreck on the coast northwest of here. I heard they used an old frozen cave to hold the product, and then used boats to transfer them out to one of their ships at night. My shipment is supposed to be on its way there now. I swear to you, that is all I know. No, I suppose it won't. Not now, at least. Yes, yes, of course. As I said, I've already made those arrangements. You needn't worry about that. Now then, I'll take my leave of you.
Thank you. check outside and make sure it's safe for us to leave? I heard that bandit say there's some others on the way to ship us out of here. Please, help us. There's my wife and son in there. I've got to help them. He's not going to make it if we don't hurry. I'll go see what I can do to get my family and the other man ready to get out of here. Please, make sure the coast is clear, and please, hurry.
This isn't permanent, but you may have a headache for a while. I suppose there's no harm in you knowing. It's a spell from a very arcane and ancient school of magic. I am one of only a few who can wield it these days. For a lesser skilled being, its effects are more harmful to the caster than the victim. In recent times, many died simply trying to learn it. But I have mastered it, even if it does leave me a little tired. But I don't think you really want to talk shop, do you? No, of course not. You've caused me quite the bit of trouble, you know. But be that as it may, I'm glad to finally meet you face to face. Yes, charming to the last, I'm sure. But you do understand that it's simply a matter of my good graces that you're still alive, don't you? Do you think that slaughtering an entire dispatch of Almeri soldiers, including two Justicias, would go unnoticed by the Dominion? But if not for me, that fetid little town you're trying to rebuild would have been razed to the ground by now, and the Thelmor would have once and for all put an end to your pitiful little band of miscreants. Of all Valerius Tiberius Arturia and his pathetic remnants of the Keepers of Hattu. Also once a great thorn in my side, and like you, caused me not a little bit of trouble in the past, but their time, his time, and yours has come to an end. I expect him to die, like all men will die or serve the Dominion. The era of men has come and gone. It is now the time of the Altmer. You know, we were once a very patient people, but that patience has worn thin. I could have killed you, but I did not. Why? Yes, good. You see, we're not so different, you and I. I killed his family and others. You killed my men. At the prison. We're both murderers. It's all just a matter of perspective. Yes. You will see that in time, if you live. You will go get Valerius Tiberius Arturia and hand him over to me in the prison where you murdered my soldiers. But there is where you're wrong. You will, or else your friend, Marcus Janus, will die. As I said, I know everything about you and your friends. I know that yesterday he decided to take a little stroll down to Riverwood. You know, you just can't be too careful these days. You never know when you might get kidnapped and brought to me. So, as you can see, you have little choice. Bring Valerius to me, and I might let Janus live. Don't bring him to me, and he will surely.